Isang mapagpalang gabi sa atin, mga kapatid, sa lahat ng taga-subaybay at taga-panood ng ating video sa gabing ito. I would like to congratulate all of you, especially the IMOE family and our missionary from different nations of the world. I would like to welcome you in this video. Tonight, we will talk about the part 3 of our series topic, Real Change of Our Life. So last, first two topics that I had been discussed to you last time, I'm discussing about why we need a real change in our life. And what are the evidence of a person who has been changed? And then I have discussed also that what are the things that we need to be changed? And then by this time, we will discuss about how to have a real change. So in this present time, we need real change as the world has using the word new normal. The word new normal, it means we need a change. We need a real change. So there's a lot of things that we need to change in our perspective, in our view, in our heart, in our minds, in our actions, even in our character, because we are in new normal situation because of the crisis that we are facing today. Now, what is change in our life is very important. Kung hindi tayo magbabago sa ating buhay sa panahong ito, mahihirapan po tayo. Mabehind po tayo. We will leave behind if we will not adapt a change in our life. That's why we call it real change of our life. We have a lot of things to be changed, especially in the spiritual area. Maybe today, all of us has been already adjusted the situations of our time, especially the preparation of our the physical things that we need to prepare and to adapt. Like the government is very busy in updating the health situation of our people in the Philippines, and even the World Health Organization is also preparing day and night to find a solution of the crisis that hampered the whole nations. But what we are talking today, tonight, is that we will talk more on spiritual change of our life. Because I believe that physical change is only the result of the spiritual change. I believe in my heart that a person to have a physical change, he must have or she must have a spiritual change in his own life. And The importance of the changes that we need to do is the change of our spiritual life more than the change of our physical life and of the material things. So go back to the questions, how to have a real change, how to obtain a real change in our life, in your life. Paano tayo magkaroon ng tunay na pagbabago sa ating buhay? Ito ang tanong na talagang dapat ating maisip, mga kapatid, brothers, sisters, and people around the world who are listening to this video. These questions is very important for us to understand how to have a real change of our life. Now, first of all, maybe we ask a word or a sentence or a question about, is real change can be done? Is real change can be achieved? I tell you, anyone who attempt or who desire to have a real change in his life, he can or they can easily achieve it. So real change is attainable and it can be achievable to those people who wants a real change. As we have discussed in my part 2 of my topic, that what are the things that we need to change. Now today I will discuss 2 points here. The first point is how to have a real change, and the second part is what are the blessings of people who are experiencing real change. Do you need to be blessed by the Lord? Do you want to be promoted? Do you want to be successful in your life? Do you want to escape the crisis that is happening today? Now, this is what we are going to do. Now, first thing that we need to do to experience and to have a real change is that we need a desire to be changed. You and I needs a desire, a will to be changed. Because it is hard to achieve change if you are not willing, if you don't have any intentions to have change in your life. Mahirap magbabago kung ikaw mismo wala kang gusto at hindi mo gusto magkaroon ng pagbabago ang buhay mo. That is why number one we need to change is we need a desire. Unless a person has a desire to be changed, you cannot achieve real change in your life. Hindi natin maranasan, mga kapatid, brothers, my fellow friends, we cannot achieve change if you don't have a desire to be changed. That is the first one that we need to consider. So if you have a desire, then we will go to the next steps. The second step is that, very simple, we need to pray that God will help us to change. In God, nothing is impossible according to Luke 1:37. Whatever things we ask in the name of the Lord will help us. Many people say to me, it's hard to change. Change is not easy thing to achieve. But I want you to know, if you have a desire to be changed, and then if you pray to God, that God will help you to change your attitude, your mindset, your heart, your character, from good, from bad to good, then I believe God will help you to change your life. Because in Jeremiah 33:3 says that, call unto me and I will answer thee and show the great and mighty things which thou knowest not. The Lord is willing to help you. The Lord is willing to help us if we are praying for Him to change our life according to the will of God. And the third one is that after we pray, after we have a desire to change and praying to change, then what the Lord's instruction to us in His Word, we will put it into practice. Put it into practice. What the things that the Lord give us to be changed, we need to put it into action. Because in James chapter 2, verse 26, it is here, in James chapter 2, verse 26. Let us read. It says here, James. For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without work is dead also. So it is not enough to pray and to desire to be changed, but after you know what things to be changed, we have to do it right away. We have to do what is right, and we have not to do what is wrong. What the things you want to change, change it. Do it right now. What the things you don't want to change, or you don't want to do again, because you know that it is wrong, it is not beneficial to you, then stop it. That's how simple the Word of God in your life. Put into practice. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 6, 26 to 27, it is also here. Matthew 7. But everyone who hears this saying of mine and does not do them, he will be like foolish man who built his house on the sand, and the wind blow and beat on that house, and it fell, and great was its fall. So it's very clear in the Bible. If we want experience real change in our life, and then we know what to do, what the Word of God instructs us to change, but we will not put it into practice, then we are just like a foolish man who built his house upon the sand. That it says here that when the wind blows and beat on that house, then that house, it fell down because it was built on the sand. So it's the same. If we hear the Word of God, And then we did not change, we did not do it, we did not put it into practice, nothing happens. Nothing changes. So these three things, how to have a real change, is very important. I will refresh it again. You need a desire to be changed. The second thing is pray to God that He will help you to be changed. Then number three, put it into practice. What the things that God wants you to change. Now let's come to points number two. What are the blessings of people who are experiencing real change? Why we need to change? How important changes in our life? Maybe some people they want change, but they are not able to achieve changes. Many people, they are already boring, they are already surrendered their life because they want change but they don't achieve change. My fellow brothers and sisters, my friend tonight, I want to help you how to be blessed by the Lord. Because one of the things that the Lord will give us if we have a real change in our life is that the Lord will release His favor and blessings upon us. Now, what are the blessings? Now, first of all, we have eternal life. The first blessing that the Lord will give us if we will change our life from believer to become believer, from bad to become good, from greedy to become giver, and so on and so forth, the first thing is that the Lord will give us eternal life. Now, this eternal life cannot be obtained by through other people. Eternal life cannot be buy in the store. It can only obtain by believing Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Eternal life is very important because when you don't have eternal life, you are not sure of your salvation, you will be put to hell. The Lord will bring you to hell if you don't have eternal life. Because it means to say, if you are not saved, you don't have eternal life because you are not a believer. Then, the second thing is that, if we have a real change in our life, we will be blessed materially and financially by the Lord. We will be blessed financially and materially from the Lord. So, real change is the key, one of the key to become blissful, to receive God's favor. Isa ito sa pamaraan. Napagpalain tayo ng Panginoon kapag tayo nagbabago. Kapag nagkaroon ka ng relasyon sa Diyos, mula sa wala kang relasyon. If you are unbeliever, so the Lord will not help you. The Lord will not give you favor unless you believe in Him. That's why the next blessing that we can have after we have a real change is that the Lord is going to bless you materially and financially. And the third one is that if we encounter real change in our life, then we will be protected, we will be promoted, by the Lord. So the Lord give us a favor, the Lord give us a promotion if we have a real change in our life. Now, I will mention two people in the Bible who has experienced real change, how the Lord blessed them tremendously, and how the Lord used them mightily in the kingdom. First person is the person of Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul, before he was converted to the Lord, he was a sinner. He was a great persecutor, a killer of the Christians. He is a number one obstacle of the preaching of the kingdom of the apostle. He's a great sinner. He has the authority from the high priest, from the law enforcer of the land of Israel to persecute the Christians, the believers of the Lord Jesus Christ. But when God chased him, when God changed his life, when Paul encountered God in the road of Damascus, Paul was totally changed. When Paul before Paul was changed, his name is Saul. But when he encountered the Lord, he was changed from Saul to Paul. His name was being changed. And after Paul was encountered the Lord, his life was totally different. He is number one persecutor, killer, sinner. But after he converted to the Lord, after he encountered real change, his life was totally changed. He was become a great preacher, a great teacher, a great apostle, a great disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. And he has bold enough to preach the gospel to all province, tribes of the Israel. And he is also the apostle to the Gentiles. So, the Lord bless Apostle Paul. The Lord use Apostle Paul. The Lord promote Apostle Paul from bad to good, and from nothing to something, from useless to become useful, from killer to become life restorer, from discourager to become encourager. That was the life of Paul. And the second thing is, the second person that I want also to encourage is the life of Abraham. Abraham, before he was changed, his name is Abraham. But when he experienced changes from the Lord, his name was changed from Abraham to Abraham. And the Lord test the life of Abraham by asking him to offer the one and only son, Isaac, whom he loved so much. Isaac, his only son, with Sarah, they don't expect that the Lord will give them a son because of their old age during this time. Excuse me. But the Lord promised to Abraham that the Lord will give him a son. And the Lord fulfilled his promise in the person of Isaac. When Isaac came out from from the world. When Isaac came out from his mother, Abraham loved so much his only begotten son. And that's why the Lord tried to test his faith. If how the Lord loves God more than his son, Isaac. And then when the Lord commands Abraham to offer his beloved son, Isaac, in the Mount Moriah, to offer to the Lord as a living sacrifice, Abraham never complained, never hesitate to offer Isaac, his son, to the Lord. Abraham was able to show his great faith, his great trust in God. That in spite of crisis, when the Lord demand his faithfulness, demand his integrity, demand his great faith, Abraham never attempt to mourn or to complain God why the Lord demand him to offer his beloved son. So Abraham, when he obeyed, after he offered Isaac, the Lord was blessed Abraham tremendously. That's why in the book of Genesis chapter 13, verse 1 and 2, it says here, Genesis chapter 13, verse 1. 12. Chapter 12, verse 1 and 2 and 3. Now the Lord had said to Abram, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great. And you shall be a blessing. And I will bless those who bless you. And I will curse him who curses you. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed. This is what happened when Abraham obeyed the Lord and experienced tremendous change in his life. The Lord bless Abraham. The Lord promote Abraham. The Lord provides the new Abraham. The Lord increase his family. Like a sun of the seashore and like the stars of the sky. And he is called the father of many nations. That's why tonight, my beloved brothers and sisters in the Lord, all who are watching this video, wherever you are today, if you are listening to me right now, if you want tremendous protections from the Lord, if you want tremendous blessings from the Lord, if you want tremendous promotion from the Lord, first of all, we need a real change in your life. So, I already elaborate, explain one by one steps how to experience real change and what are the blessings of being changed. Now, I believe tonight, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, this is what we need today. Our world is in the midst of crisis. Our nation, Philippines, is in the midst of crisis. Kailangan po talaga tayo pagbabago. Ang pinakamalagang pagbabago, the great need to change sa ating buhay ay yung ating paglapit sa Diyos sa gabi ito. Ating paglapit sa Panginoon sa panahon ito ng crisis. You know, we cannot lean any things. We cannot blame anybody. Only the Lord can trust. Only the Lord is our helper. He is our great provider. He is the source of our life. In this COVID-19 crisis, the Lord is the great healer. You may have all the money in your life. You may own a hospital. You may own a lot of things to pay your bills. But if the Lord will not allow you to be healed, if the Lord will not help us to conquer this crisis, we cannot be an overcomer. We need the Lord. You need the Lord. That's why I give you an opportunity tonight. If you are not yet received Jesus Christ, if you don't have yet relationship with Jesus Christ tonight, I want you to pray for you. May the Lord be your Savior and Lord of your life. Pray with me right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I believe I am a sinner. I believe you died on the cross of Calvary for me to have eternal life. Write my name in the book of life. And thank you for forgiving my sin. From now on, Lord, I trust you and I will serve you right now. In Jesus' name, amen. My brothers and sisters, my friend, if you are repeating that prayer with me tonight, I believe today you are now a genuine born-again Christian. You are now a pure believer. And you will experience tremendous change in your life. So, before I end this message, don't forget to subscribe in our YouTube channel. Follow in our Instagram. Like, share the message to your friend, family, loved ones, co-workers. And always listen the Word of God every time we have a video so that your faith will continue to grow. And before we will end, I pray for you right now. Father God, I pray for those people who are listening and watching today. If they are facing pain, sickness, and diseases, whether COVID-19 or not, Lord, normal sickness, Lord, I pray that the healing power of Jesus will continue to touch their body from head to foot right now. They will experience miracle healing through you, through you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, I pray also those who are in problems, in shortage of basic needs, Lord, I pray that you will continue to provide them, Lord. You are the great provider, the great supplier, Lord. We trust you, Lord. Bless our country, the Philippines. Bless the people around the world who need the Lord, that they will know you as you are there. Thank you so much, Father God. Bless us all together. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you po.